Amna Limawi is celebrating the release of her son Muhammad from prison in al-Zawiya city west of Tripoli. She came from the Libyan coastal city of Sabrata to meet him. He had been detained along with other young fighters recruited by the warlord Khalifa Haftar.
His father and I never wanted him to join the forces, but he did it behind our backs. We will never allow that to happen again.
Muhammad was among nearly 200 pro-Haftar fighters from Sabrata and Surman cities. They were captured by government forces in western Tripoli in April last year. Some of them were only 17 years old. Musbah says he had just finished high school and received a month and a half of military training in Sabrata before he was sent to the front line.
I just need to live as a civilian and move on with my life. I don't want to be part of any conflict. I learned the lesson the hard way.
The holiday of Eid is an occasion for forgiveness in Muslim countries. Government officials here say they released the fighters because the young prisoners are victims themselves.
We have taken the initiative to let them reunite with their families on this holy occasion. We hope we can exchange the rest of the prisoners with our fighters who are kept in Haftar's prisons.
The release of the prisoners was achieved through reconciliation between cities in western Libya. Other pro-Haftar inmates who are from other parts of Libya, along with foreign mercenaries, will likely remain here in detention until the conflict is resolved.
Nearly 350 inmates, including foreign nationals, are kept here in this maximum security prison. They were part of the failed military campaign to take control of Tripoli. Some of these teens say they were deceived into joining the conflict. Others say financial incentives drove them to risk their lives. Mahmoud, Abdelwahed, Al Jazeera, Al-Zawiya.